Professor Dave and Chegg here, we just learned what chirality is and how to determine whether a particular carbon qualifies as a chiral center. But there is more to discuss here, as there are different types of stereoisomers. Let's check out some more terminology.
If a molecule has precisely one chiral center, it is definitely a chiral molecule. It will have a mirror image that is a different molecule. Stereoisomers that are mirror images of one another are called enantiomers. So looking at 2-bromobutane, there is only one chiral center. So we have just these two possible stereoisomers, and these are enantiomers. They are molecules that are mirror images of one another and are not the same molecule. Some molecules are the same as their mirror image. Here are some examples. Taking the mirror image does not change the molecule. It aligns atom for atom with the original. These molecules would be considered achiral. Your hands can also be thought of as having an enantiomeric relationship, since they are mirror images of each other. In the context of molecules, again, this will result from a particular carbon atom being bound to 4 different groups. But this can happen even with more than one chiral center. Enantiomers will involve the inversion of every chiral center. No matter how many are present, inverting all of the chiral centers on one enantiomer will give the other enantiomer, which will be the mirror image. There are many molecules in nature which have enantiomeric relationships. Here are plus and minus lactic acid. We will get to what this plus and minus terminology means in a moment, but right now we simply need to understand that this molecule contains one chiral center, and the two versions are mirror images of each other, meaning inverting the chiral center produces the other enantiomer. No matter how we try to rotate one to place it directly over the other, not all of the atoms can align. 2 groups will always be mismatched, because they truly are different molecules.
As we move forward, it will be very important to be able to identify chiral centers, assign their configurations, and identify molecules as being enantiomers or other types of stereoisomers. This will become quite apparent when we learn stereospecific synthetic techniques, which give us only one stereoisomer as a product out of multiple possible stereoisomers. So practice a bit more if you need to, and move on when you're ready. Professor Dave for Chegg. See you next time.